teachers teaching different doctrines. In fact, there are some things that they are doing now as Jesus have told us that will happen. We see easy life gospel. They say you don't need to turn away from your bad ways. Just come to Jesus. Jesus is loving. And immediately you just say, Jesus, I love you. He too will love you. And whatever bad thing you do, whatever bad thing you don't do, you don't even need repentance. Just enjoy your life. You are a Christian. That is easy life gospel. They will not tell us the truth of the word of God. Some will even be teaching some things today. In the world today, they say man and woman can marry. Women and woman can marry. They say a person that is created by God, a little child, can decide by himself to become a female and that it is accepted. And they will help you to turn from being a boy to become a male. Those are doctrines of the devil. I will not follow those evil doctrines. What about you? What about you? I cannot hear you. Me, I will not be deceived by all those evil doctrines. Now, there will also be wars and rumors of wars, earthquakes in diverse places. Are we not seeing it already? That there are a lot of troubles, there are a lot of increase in famine, earthquake, pestilence, strange things in the world. As much as possible, Jesus said it before, that all these things will happen. And so we must watch out. We must do what? We must what? Watch out and avoid all those things. Also, there will be a lot of troubles in the world. When you talk about wars, look at wars in Afghanistan, Ukraine war in Russia and Ukraine, in Sudan recently. Jesus warned us, and what Jesus said will happen is already happening. So if we are going to be wise, what are we going to do? What are we going to do, children? Yes, we will watch out. Not only that, children, there will be persecution. Friends of Jesus will be killed because they decide to remain friends of Jesus. There will be backsliding because of the trouble that is in the world. Some people will say, if there is food, if Jesus God is there, why am I hungry? And before you know it, all the troubles that are now happening will make some people to forsake Christ. Is it not happening already? It is happening. So, but for me and you, that Jesus have warned us, we will watch out because Jesus Christ can come anytime from now. There will be increase of violence, terrorism, people killing people, robbery, burglary. In fact, you know, among children now, there are many kind of worldliness and evil. Some children, they go into internet. They are not searching for things about their education. All they are searching for is evil sides of immoral things, wicked things, and they are learning a lot of bad languages from the internet. Watch it. These are what Jesus Christ said will happen in the last days. And also, we have disobedience to parents. You tell a child, your mommy tells you, this is what you do, they do like this. What they say they should not do is what they will do. So children, if you don't repent very quickly, you will not be able to go with Jesus when he comes. I pray that you will not miss the coming of Jesus in Jesus' name. I cannot hear your amen. Okay, I pray for myself. I will not miss the coming of Jesus in Jesus' name. Now, what should you do to prepare? What must I do to prepare? The sinner must repent and turn away from his sins. Surrender your life totally to for Jesus. And if you are already a friend of Jesus, you gave your life to Jesus during this program, you will decide you will continue to follow Jesus until he comes. I will not be left behind. What do you say? Your confession will be your possession. I will not be left behind. The Lord will help you. But for you and me not to be left behind, we have to commit our life again unto the Lord. You want to rise up on your feet? You want to pray? You want to ask that, Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Come in to stay in my heart. I don't want to be here when the great trouble, the great tribulation will happen. I say you should rise up on your feet. We want to pray, and it's a serious time. Don't miss it. Some people are still sitting down as if they are not hearing. Those are what we are talking. I pray you will not be left behind. Are you a sinner? Confess your sins and ask Jesus to come into your heart now. Turn away from all your wicked ways. Jesus gave us this warning to avoid the deception that are coming from all the false prophets, and so that these bad things that are going to happen will not meet us by surprise. Won't you pray? Won't you pray to be ready when the Lord shall come? In Jesus' name, we pray. I want to be ready. We want to be ready. Our Father and our God, you have given us your word. Help us to hide this word on the table of our hearts. Every day we'll be looking out, watching for your coming. Because you have told us that your coming will come suddenly. We pray that none of us will miss the rapture in Jesus' name. As many boys and sinners that are sinners, as many girls that are sinners, as they are coming before you this morning, forgive everyone in Jesus' name. And all of us that have decided to follow Jesus, help us by your power, help us by your grace to follow Jesus to the end in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, for the answer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
We shout, standing tall as rising stars. Stars! We want the whole globe to shout it, because this is a generation of rising stars. Stars! And when I say standing tall as rising stars, you shout stars. Standing tall as rising stars! Wonderful how the globe, we all shout stars, and everybody is becoming stars. This is the time for children choir from the Alpha location. I've been listening. God bless you.
Blessed are the unfound in the way, who walk in the law of the Lord. Blessed are they that keep his testimonies and that seek him with the whole heart. They also do know iniquity, they walk in his ways. Thou hast commanded us to keep thy precepts diligently.
Can you take verse 7?
I will praise thee with uprightness of heart when I shall make thy righteous judgment.
What of verse 32?
I will remind you of thy commandments when thou shalt delight in my heart. My name is Margaret Harid.
When did you learn Samuel?
December 26.
Who told you to learn Samuel?
My mom. She helped me through the spellings and pronunciation.
Did you use a digital Bible or physical paper Bible?
Paper Bible.
Alright, was it yours?
Yes.
Give us verse 12.
Verse 12. Blessed are thou, O Lord, teach me thy status.
You've been able to give us verses without checking it. So how did you learn that?
I started with the numbers before I stopped. But I still remember the numbers.
Okay. You are a student of which school?
D&G school.
So, can you do verse 15?
Verse 15. This is my comfort in my affliction, for the word has spoken me.
I will go to check if she's right. Oh, she's right. Okay, let's go to verse
1 and 7. Lead thou upon me and hold thou me up, and I shall be saved. And I will have respect unto thy status continually.
Okay, she's right. So, thank you. Now, I'm asking again, lastly. Which book of the Bible, apart from Psalm 109, are you planning to go and read?
I would love to recite the book of Genesis, chapter 1 to 10.
Thank you.
Hold that my ways are directed to keep thy statutes. Then shall I not be ashamed, and I have respect unto all thy commandments. I will praise thee with uprightness of heart, and I shall have learned thy righteous judgments. I will keep thy status, O forsake me not utterly. Wherewith thou shalt hear my cleanses way, by taking heed thereto according to thy word. With my whole heart have I sought thee, O let me not wander from thy commandments. Thy word have I hid in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. Blessed art thou, O Lord, teach me thy status. With my lips have I declared all the judgments of thy mouth. I have rejoiced in the way of thy testimonies as much as in all riches. I will meditate in thy precepts and have respect unto thy ways. I will delight myself with thy statutes and will not forget thy word. Deal bountifully with thy sermons, that I may live and keep thy word. Open thou my eyes, that I may build wondrous things out of thy law. I am a stranger in the earth, hide not thy commandments from me. My soul breaketh for the longing, that he hath also thy judgment at all times. Thou hast rebuked the proud that are caused, which you err from thy commandment. Remove from me reproach and contest, for I have kept thy testimonies. Princes also did sin and speak against me, but I soundly meditate in thy statutes. Thy testimonies also are my delight and my counselor. My soul cleaveth unto the dust, quick in thou me according to thy word. I have declared my ways, and thou addest me, teaching thy statutes. Make me to understand the way of thy precepts. So shall I talk of thy wondrous work. My soul matters for heaviness. Strengthen thou me according unto thy word. Remove from me the way of lying, and grant me thy law graciously. I have seen the way of truth. Thy judgments have I laid before me. I have spoken to thy testimonies. O Lord, put me not to shame. I will warn the world thy commandments when thou shalt enlarge my heart. Teach me, O Lord, the word thy statutes, and I shall keep it unto the end. Give me understanding, and I shall keep thy law. Yea, I shall observe with my whole heart. Make me to go in the path of thy commandments, for therein do I delight.
Incline my heart unto thy testimonies, and not to covetousness. Turn away my eyes from beholding vanity. Quicken thou me in thy way.
action.
I understand more than the ancient because I kept that precept. My name is Jeremiah Ibegbe, and the name of my school is Junior Grammar School. Gave me words of encouragement, and all my siblings helped me doing the practicing or recite. Like if I want to, if I've crammed it, I've memorized it, then I'll recite it before them. Which is devoted to thy fear. Turn away my reproach, which I fear, for thy judgment are good. Behold, I longed after thy precepts, quicken me in thy righteousness. Let thy mercies come also unto me, O Lord, even thy salvation, according to thy word. So shall I have wherewith to answer him that reproacheth me, for I trust in thy word, and take not the word of truth utterly out of my mouth, for I have hoped in thy judgment. So shall I keep thy law continually forever and ever. And I will walk at liberty, for I seek thy precepts. I will speak of thy testimonies also before kings. I will not be ashamed. I will delight myself in thy commandment which I have loved. My hands also will I lift up unto thy commandments which I have loved. I will meditate in thy statutes. Remember the word unto thy servants, upon which thou hast caused me to hope. This is my comfort in my affliction, for thy word hath quickened me. The proud had me greatly in derision, yet have I not declined from thy law. I remember thy judgment of old, O Lord, and have comforted myself. Horror hath taken hold upon me, because of the wicked that forsake thy law. Thy statutes had been my song in the house of my pilgrimage. I remember thy name, O Lord, in the night, and have kept thy law. This I had because I kept thy precepts. Thou art my portion, O Lord. I have said that I would keep thy word. I entreated thy favor with my whole heart. Be merciful unto me according to thy word. I thought on my ways and turned my feet unto thy testimonies. I made haste and delayed not to keep thy commandments. The bands of the wicked have robbed me, but I have not forgotten thy law. At midnight I will rise to give thanks to thee because of thy righteous judgments. I am a companion of all them that fear thee and of them that keep thy precepts. The earth, O Lord, is full of thy mercies. Teach me thy statutes. Thou hast dealt well with thy servant, O Lord, according to thy word. Teach me good judgment and knowledge, for I have believed in thy commandments. Before I was afflicted, I went astray, but now I have kept thy word. Thou art good and doest good. Teach me thy statutes. The proud hath forged a lie against me, but I will keep thy precepts. My whole heart. Their heart is as fat as grease, but I delight in thy law. It is good for me that I have been afflicted, that I might learn thy statutes. The law of thy mouth is better unto me than thousands of gold and silver. Thy hands have made me and fashioned me. Give me understanding that I may learn thy commandments. They that fear thee will be glad when they see me, because they have hoped in thy word. I know, O Lord, that thy judgments are right, and that thou in faithfulness hast afflicted me. Let, I pray thee, thy merciful kindness be for my comfort, according to thy word unto thy servants. Let thy tender mercies come also unto me, that I may live, for thy law is my delight. Let be proud be ashamed, for thou dealt purposely with me without a cause, but I will meditate in thy precepts. Let those that fear thee turn unto me, and those that have known thy testimonies. Let my heart be sound in thy statutes, that I be not ashamed. My soul fainted for thy salvation, but I hope in thy word. My eyes fail for thy word, saying, when wilt thou comfort me?
For I am become like a bottle in the smoke, yet do I not forget thy statutes. How many are days of thy servant? When will thy execute judgment on them? Execute me. The proud are deep pit for me, which are not for them. I don't know, but anyone that comes to my bed, I'm not sure, but I know it's marvelous, blah, blah, blah. I know my school is the perfect educational foundation. I guess it was up to 2 weeks. Yeah, I saw it. No, because he studied it at the, I saw it last year when my dad promised to get me a phone if I can recite it. So I did it, and that was actually my first time doing it. Well, like, I could not do it, but at least I did it. Yeah, I got it.
Alright, so, how
are these helps? It makes me, like, feel like I can just go to life. Like, I know 405, there was a lamp onto my feet and a light onto my path, 100. I understand more than the ancient because I keep that precept, 101. I have received my feet from every field, and I might keep my word from the line. Where would those be your mom? Glasses we by taking it dead, so God is my word. I can't say now. What would I command men are faithful? They persecute me wrongfully, help down me. They have almost consumed me upon earth, but I forsook not thy precepts. Quicken me after thy loving kindness, so shall I keep the testimony of thy mouth forever, O Lord. Thy word is settled in heaven. Thy faithfulness is unto all generations. Thou hast established the earth and it abided. They continue this day according to thy ordinances, for all are thy servants. Unless thy law had been my delight, I should then have perished in my affliction. I will never forget thy precepts, for with them thou hast quickened me. I am dying, save me, for I have sought thy precepts. The wicked have waited for me to destroy me, but I will consider thy testimony. I have seen an end of all perfection, but thy commandments are exceeding broad. Oh, how I love thy law. It is my meditation all the day. Thou, through thy commandments, hast made me wiser than my enemy, for they are ever with me. I understand. I have more understanding than all my teachers, for thy testimonies are my meditation. I understand more than the ancient, because I keep thy precepts. I have refrained my feet from every evil way, that I might keep thy word. I have not departed from thy judgments, for thou hast taught me. How sweet are thy words unto my taste, yea, sweeter than honey to my mouth. Through thy precept I get understanding, therefore I hate every false way. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet, and a light unto my path. I have sworn, and now perform it, and I will keep thy righteous judgments. I am afflicted very much, quicken me, O Lord, according to thy word. Accept, I beseech thee, the free reluctance of my mouth, O Lord, and teach me thy judgments. My soul is continually in my hand, yet do I not forget thy law. The wicked have laid a snare for me, yet I err not from thy precepts. Thy testimony I have taken as an heritage forever, for they are the rejoicing of my heart. I have inclined my heart to perform thy statutes always, even unto the end. I hate vain thoughts, but thy law do I love. Thou art my hiding place and my shield, I hope in thy word. Depart from me, ye evildoers, for I will keep the commandments of my God. Uphold me according to thy word, that I may live, and let me not be ashamed of my hope. Hold thou me up, and I shall be saved, and I will have respect unto thy statutes continually. Thou hast turned down all them that err from thy statutes, for their disease is falsehood. Thou puttest away all the wicked of the earth like dross. Therefore I love thy testimonies. My flesh trembled for fear of thee,
and am afraid of thy judgment. I have done judgment and justice. Lead me not to my oppressors. Be surety for thy servants for good. Let not the proud oppress me. My eyes feel for thy salvation and for the word of thy righteousness. Deal with thy servant according to thy mercy and teach me thy statutes. Make thy face to shine upon thy servant. It is time for the Lord to walk, for they have made void thy law. Therefore, I love thy commandments above good, yea, above fine gold. Therefore, I esteem thy precept concerning all things to be right, and I hate every false way. Thy testimonies are wonderful, therefore doth my soul keep them. The entrance of thy word giveth light, it giveth understanding unto the simple. I opened my mouth and panted, for I long for thy commandment. Look thou upon me, and be merciful unto me, as thou hast done unto those that love thy name. Order my steps in thy word, and let not any iniquity have dominion over me. Deliver me from the oppression of man, so will I keep thy precepts. Make thy face to shine upon thy servant, and teach me thy statutes. Rivers of water has run down my eyes, because they kept not thy law. Righteous art thou, O Lord, and upright are thy judgments. Thy testimony that thou hast commanded are righteous and very faithful. My zeal has consumed me, because my enemy has forgotten thy words. Thy word is very pure, therefore thy servant loveth it. I am small and despised, yet do not I forget thy precepts. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and thy law is the truth. Trouble and anguish have taken hold on me, yet thy commandments are my delight. The righteousness of thy testimony is everlasting. Give me understanding, and I shall live. I cried my whole heart, hear me, O Lord, I will keep thy statutes. I cry unto thee, save me, and I shall keep thy testimony. I prevented the dawning of the morning, and cried, I hope in thy word. My eyes prevent the night watches, that I might meditate in thy word. Hear my voice, according to thy loving kindness, O Lord, quicken me, according to thy judgment. They draw near, that follow after mischief, they are far from thy law.
Thou art near, O Lord, and all thy commandments are truth. Concerning thy testimonies, I have no abode that thou appointed them forever. Consider my affliction and deliver me, for I do not forget thy law. Plead my cause and deliver me, quicken me according to thy word. Salvation are far from the wicked, for they seek not thy statutes. Great are thy tender mercies, O Lord, quicken me according to thy judgment. Many are my persecutors and my enemies, yet I decline from thy testimonies. I beheld your transgressors, I was grieved, because I kept not thy word. Consider how I love thy precepts, quicken me, O Lord, according to thy loving kindness. Thy word is true from the beginning, and every one of thy righteous judgments endures forever. Princes have persecuted me without a cause, but my heart standeth in awe of thy word. I rejoice at thy word as one that findeth great spoil.
I hate and abhor lying, but thy law do I love. 7 times a day do I praise thee because of thy righteous judgments. Great peace have they which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them. Lord, I have hoped for thy salvation, and have done thy commandments. My soul hath kept thy testimonies, and I love them exceedingly. I've kept thy precepts and thy testimonies, for all my ways are before thee. Let my cry come near before thee, O Lord. Give me understanding according to thy word. Let my supplication come before thee. Deliver me according to thy word.
My lips shall utter praise when thou hast taught me thy statutes. My tongue shall speak of thy word, for all thy commandments are righteousness. Let thy hand help me, for I have chosen thy precepts. I have longed for thy salvation, O Lord, and thy law is my delight. Let my soul live, and it shall praise thee, and let thy judgment help me. I have gone astray like a lost sheep. Seek thy servant, for I do not forget thy commandments. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. I will advise all children.
Can we stand up and give these rising stars a standing ovation? Please stand up and give them a standing ovation. I need more of this. More of this. These are rising stars. These are rising stars. Psalm 119, from 1 to 176. Please, more. Can we shout stars? The Lord will make you a star. And all our children will become stars. In Jesus' name. Thank you very much. You may have your seats. We now go to the next session of today's family worship, the youth variety and song. We'll now be welcoming spoken word from Deeper Life High School. Spoken word from Deeper Life High School. Just come to the stage quickly and let's have your presentation. You have a very limited time, please.
Jesus loves you just too much. Stand tall as rising stars. A star never rests until it shines first.
Even when it's not nominated,
forever distinguishes, never diminishes.
Shine so bright like an unquenchable light.
A star is always hidden until it's time for it to be risen.
It's never underrated. Even when it is underestimated,
a star shines in the midst of darkness, brightens the room in the middle of sadness.
People with stars, yes, people like you, encourage others to keep moving on. They teach others that when they fall, they have to keep pushing on.
A star's light can never dim or rust, but to brighten others has to be a must.
A star's light can be penetrated, and its effect to others can't be confiscated.
Just like Joseph in the Bible, no one would have ever believed that he would move from pit to prison to palace then to being prime minister.
And also like Daniel, whose star shone so bright against all odds.
For your star, yes, that star in view of you to shine bright, you have to push all things aside, be spiritually inclined, and your testimonies you will see outlined.
Stand tall as a rising star, then you know your success isn't far.
Let your star shine bright like diamonds in the sky.
A star doesn't compete with others, it just shines. A rose doesn't answer its envy, but with beauty and without a dime.
Stars don't pull each other down, they have varied illuminations. The world doesn't accommodate for fitting in, but for an erudite generation.
Never under-
You will burn to dazzle, yes, you. Don't let anyone make you fizzle.
Stars are made to sparkle. Typically, you're already a spectacle.
A star that is reserved in the limelight cannot be hidden in the daylight.
But when gloominess tries to stop you from your stardom, it's time you radiate into your freedom.
Stars bring light to the dark, and that's what makes a significant mark.
The fullness of their mind will surely ignite, although they know it's no birthright.
Even as failures rage, successfully they emerge.
Be like a star, always inquisitive, everywhere they are, known as executive.
People think being a star is nothing, and they think being a star has nothing to bring.
Youth of today do not think like this, if not with an opportunity missed.
Sometimes I wish the clock should stop, to look back at everything, to correct what I've done wrong.
Looking back at everything, I try not to turn. Who then do I mourn?
When our plans fail to crystallize and our dreams fail to visualize.
Our understanding fails to realize, the discipline to actualize, the dream to become a star.
Since we fail to pick up the good opportunity, blaming it on laziness as a common disability.
We lose self-confidence, discipline, courage, passion, and integrity.
Without those characters, we lack self-stability.
Striving to success, yes, striving to success means taking up those opportunities.
Don't let it slip past you, or else you end up in misery.
When you miss all this, life will give you sympathy.
Better treasure them all now, or else failure won't give you liberty.
Looking back at this current one, I try not to be dumbfounded.
In this current state of globalization, corruption, yes, corruption takes its crown.
Those this current state of devastation, corruption takes its crown. Our talents we have uncovered. Our dreams we have discovered.
Those stars we are yet to recover. Matthew 5:16 says,
let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify that which is in heaven.
No more holding back, for it's our time to move forward. No room for lack, for it's our time to be honored. Where the word of a king is, remember there is power. We are the ones to rule and reign and not to cower. When we step in with light, taking over territories and reaching the highest heights. There once was a time when darkness ruled with strength and fame, but now the stars are risen, putting them to shame and ruling with grace. We have the ability to stand up boldly, kinging with grace and glory. No more fear, no more worry. We are the ones to change the story. No limitations, for we rule the nations as we stand tall as rising stars.
We believe in you. Now is your chance to stand up for us, rising stars. Thank you, and God bless you.
We believe in you. You are the next rising stars. Please, another round of applause. Let us celebrate the grace of God in these rising stars. Amen. I believe all over the globe, the generation of stars, through the covenant, Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumi, we will have them many in Jesus' name. We now move to the next, which is the brass ensemble by the choir, the quartet. God bless you.
started out with Jesus at a very early age. Yes, I've known him nearly all of my life. Well, I admitted every time that I faltered along the way, but I'll keep trying. Somehow I'm gonna make it in. You see, I've got a charge on my life, but I've got a job to do. But I can't stop until it's true.
I'm determined.
I'm
determined. I can't stand around wasting my time. I'm gonna keep on working for Jesus.
I'll be walking. Have time to waste criticizing someone else. There are the things I'd rather leave behind. I have to say this now. I don't have time to be bothered with she say, that he say, that they say. Cause there are a lot of things I gotta keep myself in line. I'm walk while it's day, cause I know the night is surely coming. I'm going all the way. You wanna say you can't stand around wasting your time while you're talking. Gonna keep on walking. I have Jesus on my mind. Say what you wanna say.
Wasting your time.
heaven on my mind. Heaven will be on our minds, and we will all make it to heaven in Jesus' name. Amen. We shall rise up now to sing together from Gospel Hymns and Song number 253. Gospel Hymns and Song number 253. That is on the fourth page of our program sheets, the youth program sheet, My Portion Forever. All to Jesus I consecrate anew. He is my portion forever. Only His glory henceforth will I pursue. He is my portion forever. All to Jesus my trusting heart can say. He is my portion forever. Led by his mercy, I'm walking every day. He is my portion forever. Though he may try me, this blessed truth I know. He is my portion forever. He will not leave me. His promise tells me so. He is my portion forever. All to Jesus I cheerfully resign. He is my portion forever. I have the witness that He, my Lord, is mine. He is my portion forever. Take the world with all its gilded toys. Take the world, I covet not its joys. Mine is the wealth no moth nor rust destroys. Jesus, my portion forever.
Thank you.
shall remain standing as we go to the Lord in prayer. I want us to bless the name of the Lord for this day family worship that the Lord has brought us together. Let's bless the name of the Lord for this program Stars that the Lord has brought to pass. Let's thank the Lord for the vision that the Lord gave to the man of God, and he has planted it in all our hearts and our hands. Let's thank God for the preparation. Let's thank God for the performance of this program. Let's thank God for all that the Lord has done. The Lord has imparted upon our children, upon our youth. Let's thank God for the grace that he has given to them. We want to thank the name of the Lord. Let's praise God for the church, how the church is marching forward despite all challenges, despite all difficulties, despite all trials. The church is marching forward. Let's praise God for his presence in the church. Let's praise God for the power of God in the church, the power to save, the power to heal, the power to deliver, the power to grow the church. Let's give him praise. Our God is good. Thank God for your own life, how the Lord has been sustaining you from this beginning of this year to this time. His name be praised forevermore. In Jesus' name we pray. I love your amen. This is the amen that is required from people that stars, their stars are shining. I want to hear in Jesus' name. We want to pray for the nation. We are going to thank God for his intervention in all war prevailing nations. And we are going to tell God, manifest yourself in all this nation. And God will break every barrier. God will break down every barrier that is hindering gospel penetration in all nations. Because the desire of God that is that the gospel of peace will reach out to all nations. Let us declare peace. Let's pray that the Lord will bring peace to nations, to families, to everywhere, and the Lord will do it. In Jesus' name we pray. As we have come to worship the Lord, we are here to worship him with our soul, with our substance, and with all sacrifice. The Bible says in Luke chapter 6, verse 38, give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down, shaking together, and running over, shall men give into your bosom. For with the same measure that he met with that, it shall be measured to you again. It is time to give our tithe and our offering. So wherever you are, just put it in your pockets, in your bags, and raise up your offering unto the Lord. Our Father, in the name of Jesus, we have come to worship you. We bring in our soul. We also bring our substance. Lord, we pray that you will receive this offering that is coming to you, and you will bless it and bless the giver in return in Jesus' name. Those who don't have, provide for them so that next time when we come, they will be able to sacrificially give unto you. Thank you for hearing us. In Jesus' name we pray. You may open your eyes and drop your offering as the ushers are passing the bag around. And those of us that you want to pay, you can pay into the church account. The church account is there, and those of us online, the account number is being streamed online. And pay, transfer into it, and the Lord will receive your offering. As you give your offering, we'll still remain standing as we go to the Lord in prayer. Prayer for the general superintendent. Want to pray for Pastor Dr. W.F. Fumi. I want to pray that God will grant him strength, more strength in the inner man. Strength in the inner man. Let's pray for him. As the Lord is raising him up, God will grant him more strength in the inner man. Let's pray in his ministry for more privileges, more open doors God will give to him. Let's pray that the Lord will give him good health. He will be strong. Strong at heart. Strong in the body. Strong in the bone. Let's pray the Lord will make him youthful in his days. Let's pray that he will see the impact, the fruit of his ministry, and his soul will be glad. Let's pray for his family, that the Lord will uphold them, the Lord will keep them, and the Lord will bless them. In Jesus' name we pray. Want you to pray for families. Challenges abound in the family. Let's pray that God will heal families. We bring restoration to families. There will be recovery in all families. There will be rest. Where there are troubles, where there are challenges, let God bring rest. Let God bring solution, and it shall be so. In Jesus' name we pray. Before we round up, can you pray for yourself? What is it that you want the Lord to do for you? What is it that you are asking God to do? God is here to answer your prayer. Tell him now, and he's hearing you. In Jesus' name we pray. The offering bag is still being passed around. You can signify, and then you drop your offering. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, we thank you for such a day like this. This is beautiful. The day you have made us to see how you are raising up stars, raising up generation of stars, oh God. I pray that heaven will continue to rejoice over us, over the family, over the church, over the leadership, over the nations. In Jesus' name, all that you have prayed concerning nation, break down barriers to gospel penetration. Raise up more laborers, zealous, fervent laborers, in the mighty name of Jesus. All that you have prayed for the church, keep your church strong, that the doctrine will not be watered down. Raise up men and women that will uphold the truth, and the church will keep marching forward. And we pray families, peace be restored, healing and deliverance. Make the family to be together again. And we are here to worship you today. Distribute the bread of life. Let every longing soul be satisfied. Bless your people in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you very much. You may have your seat. Amen. When I look around, I see stars coming out of a stadium. This is where people begin to make stars. And stars are coming out of this place. If you are one of them, can you shout stars? I love to do one thing. Stars don't sit down. Stars are up. When I say stars, you say standing tall as rising stars. And as you are doing it, you are standing up all over the globe. Because today, God is raising up stars everywhere. So when I say stars, you stand up and you stretch your hand like a star. I say standing tall as rising stars. Stars! Beautiful. Amen. God bless you. You may have your seats. You know why I've done that? There are new stars here today. You have been invited for this program. This is your first time of worshiping with Deeper Life Bible Church. You are the new star. The man of God is happy that you are here.
And so we want to recognize you. This is the first time you are coming for such a program like this. Can you please signify by raising of your hands? All over the churches, all over the globe. This is the first time you are coming to the church. Can you please signify by raising of your hands? Wherever you are, can you please stand up as a star? God bless you. Stand up as a star. Raise it up properly. Wave your hand. Wave it. God bless you. Amen. Our ushers are close by. You'll be given a sleeve to feed. Please fill it and then return it back to them. I want to say again that the General Superintendent, Pastor Dr. W.F. Kumi, is happy that you are here. And he will want me to tell you that please keep coming. What he has done, what God has done through him to bless many people, he wants to see that privilege that you also are blessed. Amen. Weekly meetings. Three times we meet for special program. On Sunday, we have a Sunday devotional service starting with enriching search the scripture. The time is 8 a.m. But we do well to attend the preview prayer, the pre-meeting prayer by 7:30. On Monday, we have a systematic and expository study of God's word. The time is 6 p.m. And then on Thursday, we have Thursday Revival and Evangelism Training Service. Time is 6 p.m. You can join the location that is nearby you all over. Special banquet rally. I'm so excited because I see stars that are shining. In this program and all over, there are stars that God has gotten. We're having a special banquet rally for all those who gave their life to Christ, all children, all youths, all over. You are the new stars. Your star will shine. There's a special banquet rally for you next Sunday, 21st, May 2023. In all regional headquarters, all provincial headquarters, and all group headquarters. The time is 4 p.m. So if you are here and you have given your life to Christ, you have rededicated your life to Christ as a child, as a youth, make sure you attend the program. I want to plead with our parents to help us bring the children and the youth to attend the special banquet that is organized next Sunday. God bless you all. It's time for Bible reading.
Before the Sunday message today, we shall have a brief period of scripture reading.
The first epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Corinthians. The first epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Corinthians. 1 Corinthians 5. 1 Corinthians 5.
It is reported commonly that there is fornication among you, and such fornication as is not so much as named among the Gentiles, that one should have his father's wife. And ye are puffed up, and have not rather mourned that he that hath done this deed might be taken away from among you. For I verily, as absent in body, but present in spirit, have judged already, as though I were present, concerning him that hath so done this deed. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, when ye are gathered together, and my spirit with the power of our Lord Jesus Christ, to deliver such an one unto Satan for the destruction of the flesh, that the spirit may be saved in the day of the Lord Jesus. Your glorying is not good. Know ye not that a little leaven leaveneth the whole lump? Purge out therefore the old leaven, that ye may be a new lump, as ye are unleavened, for even Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore let us keep the feast, not with old leaven, neither with the leaven of malice and wickedness, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. I wrote unto you in an epistle not to company with fornicators, yet not altogether with the fornicators of this world, or with the covetous, or extortioners, or with idolaters, for then must ye needs go out of the world. But now I have written unto you not to keep company, if any man that is called a brother be a fornicator, or covetous,